Hi, I'm Cressel Anderson. This is Makercise. In this episode,
I'll finish mounting the ram to the shaper column. After I attached the ram slide to the ram, I put it on the surface plate to print it, and I just took care of some of the really highest spots. That tended to be towards the end, and I think that was where the shear kind of deformed the cold rolled when it was cut to length. I filed that off, then I attached sandpaper to the bottom and sides of the ram slide, and then I used that assembly to clean up the inside channel of the column. I focused on trying to widen out the column so that that way the gib would fit in between a scrap piece of cold rolled. After I had the sides cleaned up, I focused on the shelves on the column. So I removed sandpaper from the sides to make those safe edges, essentially. That way it wouldn't take off more material. And I could really focus on the bottom part that rides along those little shelves on the interior of the column sides. After I had it roughed in using the sandpaper method, I took the sandpaper off and got started scraping. And basically this process was applying the Prussian blue paint to that assembly, riding it back and forth in the ram slide channel, and then scraping down the high spots. Another trick that I've been using is to take out the blade from a hacksaw and then use that as kind of a single point cutting tool to separate the pads on the side and the bottom of the column slide channel.
What I've noticed is that as I'm printing in this ram slide channel in the column, when I turn it, it distorts the channel just enough that, you know, I had both these sides pretty much in alignment, turned it around, and now it's hitting on the back corner over here, but not up at the front. I think it is time to go ahead and get the vertical slide ways aligned and perpendicular to the ram slide, drill the holes, tap the holes, and then I think, regardless of how I turn it, this column is going to be a much more repeatable, not going to have that tendency to skew the left side relative to the right side.
All right. Perhaps you'll recall that for these two fasteners, I really had a pretty bad misalignment. Like these weren't perpendicular at all, and I just kind of freehanded it. In the comments, somebody suggested using a bench block, and I think that's pretty much what I made here out of some 5/8 inch cold rolled steel stock. So I can put in my drill bit. This is a 5 millimeter hole, kind of to get it aligned, and then I clamp this bad boy into place, and once that's in place, of course, and then once that's in place, And then on up to the next size. This is an 8mm bit, and the hole inside is 5.5, and that's so that I can put a M8 by 1.25mm fastener into this hole. I need to drill this out to 8mm, but only through the side column. I don't want to drill into the column front, and so I put a little Sharpie mark on my drill bit about where I want it to end. This is to tap the hole.
Once all the printing looked pretty good, I turned my attention to finishing off the tops of the column sides. And I did that just using my little scrap piece of cold rolled as a gauge, and then I used a rasp to help me quickly remove material. After that was not quick enough, I switched over to a belt sander, which was much faster. I think I was using about a 60 grit sandpaper belt. Then I did finish up with the rasp, which seems to do pretty good for removing material. Not as quick as the belt sander, though.
So pretty much what I've been doing is I use this little piece of cold rolled steel as a straight edge to allow me to check with a feeler gauge how far I've shaved off the column side top where the ram slide clamps will mount. I want these to be a little bit below this surface, but I'm going to scrape these parts, so for the time being, I just really want to get it as close to level, and that reduces the amount of scraping that I'll have to do. I've kind of worked over the back, and you can see there's a pretty decent sized gap there.
So there's six. Probably like 6.5 on this side,
and pretty well in line on that side. So it looks like I probably need to take off about the most here, a little bit less here and here. Then I take a file and run it across, and the rasp kind of makes a little bit of a rounded edge on this side, so I don't want to take it all the way down with that. This file seems to do a little bit better job kind of just narrowing in on the top of this gauge plate that I've got in the channel.
I went ahead and put some Prussian blue oil paint on the surface plate, and I printed this column top, and now I'm going to go ahead and scrape it in.
So you can see after a single round of scraping how much that's already improved. The channel was terribly difficult, I think mostly just because it's kind of in a recess. These flat surfaces, kind of where you can actually get at it, it seems to go fairly quickly. I pretty well have this scraped in. However, I must have taken a little bit much off the corner because you can tell that there is a good little gap there on the corner. So this is rounded off enough that I'll just have to put in an extra shim there or something on the corner. I'm not going to scrape down the rest of this surface enough to compensate for it.
After I had the tops pretty well where I wanted them, I drilled holes in one side of the column. These holes are for the gib adjustment screws. I'm using 5mm by 0.8mm set screws. After I had the holes drilled, I tapped them with the appropriate taps and then cut the ram slide clamps to length and got started drilling those for installation atop the columns. I match drilled holes in the ram slide clamps and the column sides, and then I enlarged those holes on the drill press, and I went back over to the column, then went ahead and tapped the holes using the ram slide clamps as a guide. I attached a couple of the holes using fasteners, and then I repeated the process for the remaining holes. going back and forth to the drill press, match drilling, using the tap, and then finally installing the ram slide clamp hardware.
I got both ram slide clamps installed, as well as the gib adjustment screws. The gib is installed, and I probably need to clean it up a bit. I think there's some gunk on this right side slide, but it's moving freely. I probably need to install some shims and tighten these bolts down, but for the time being, you know, the chapter 2 stuff from the book is complete, so happy about that. Next up is casting the bearing support and miscellaneous hardware associated with the ram crank.
Those of you who are supporting me on Patreon, I really appreciate your support. I hope this project builds your confidence to exercise your inner maker. Thanks for watching.